Guys, welcome to the Christmas concert. Seems like just a month ago you were here. Yay! This is officially the start of the Webb Christmas season, right? December 1st. We don't waste any time. No grass is growing under our feet. All right, you've got the concert program. First is Strings 1, Sleigh Ride in the Park. Just put your mind there. All the snow that's going to be falling. But it started raining out there. Temperature's supposed to drop 30 degrees before we get out of here tonight. It's going to be covered in snow.
Thank you.
philosophies, another cramp you choose from. You chose one. You chose chocolate. Keep chocolate in mind. Chocolate will come back later in our thoughts.
Thank you.
So now, as you remember chocolate, as you remember candy canes, they got together and made peppermint bark. Okay. And so now peppermint bark is the little baby. He's kind of a toddler, learning how to walk, kind of rowdy. So enjoy peppermint bark. carol by Leontovich, a Ukrainian, who wrote the Ukrainian bell carol, imagine that. He wrote it about 1916. It was not originally called Carol of the Bells. It was really based on the Greek Orthodox calendar, and it was supposed to ring in the new year, which was in January, and it was about a sparrow who came in the window to tell the family that they were going to have a plentiful year, their harvest would be good, his wife would be beautiful, and then everything would be great. And then 20 years later, the piece was heard in the States, and it was a choir piece, and the conductor said, "That sounds like bells. It just sounds bell-like." And completely changed the lyrics to what you know. You know, Merry, 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 Merry Christmas. And so changed it all. So 20 years later, it was published in the States as Carol of the Bells instead of the original title, which meant Bountiful. So I know you come here for history lessons. So that's
thank you.
I'm going to try to give you a couple facts about the Hallelujah Chorus that you don't know. You probably know a lot. You probably know that Handel was German, and this was composed in 17, oh goodness, I wish Janet were here, 22, I think. He wasn't living in Germany when he composed it. In fact, he composed it between August 22nd and September 14th. So don't any seniors come complaining how they can't get their theses done in an entire 5 or 6 months, okay, on campus, because he wrote the entire Messiah between those dates. It was premiered in Dublin, Ireland. He was living in London at the time, but he hadn't been getting very good reviews from the people and the society in London, so he decided, he got an invitation to perform at the Great Music Hall on Fish Amble Drive. It's a really, not a very conspicuous building, I've been there, but it was just perfect for him. It seated about 600, give or take, and because the reviews people were so excited about it, they had a ticketed dress rehearsal, you could go hear it, and people were very excited. They expected a lot of people. The advertisement said, ask that ladies please not wear their hoop skirts, and men please don't bring your swords. So I hope nobody brought either of those things tonight. That was so that they could fit more people, and they did cram about 700 in a room for 600. So anyway, this is obviously just the Hallelujah Chorus. Now, when King George first heard this, he was so moved, he stood, and of course when the king stands, y'all stand. Is Mr. Cheeseman here tonight? Okay, yes. If you stand, sir, and there's no judgment upon you if you don't, because you stand and you're like, oh, this is only short like that coffee and tea period. It's longer than that. So if you don't want to stand for a good 4 minutes, no one's going to judge you. Judge-free zone. But if Mr. Cheeseman stands, it's all up to you, buddy. So you be you, but please don't feel obligated to stand. It's a tradition because King George stood. Like I said, when the king stood, everybody stood. But this is the Hallelujah Chorus to give you a teaser for next Thursday's Lessons and Carols, which of course will be joined with choir at that time.
Thank you.
the trouble to drive here, sit in these pews, and listen to your friends, children, whatever they are to you. Thank you. Parents, a special, special thank you. You don't know what it means for these kids to have your support and your time, your energy, your willingness to let them practice, the willingness to get them instruments and support them. It means the world that they have this in their lives, however it fits in. Thank you for that. It's an incredible gift they have to be able to take orchestra at school for many years. Not every school has it. Most schools don't have it. So thank you for that. Thank you to the parents who helped put together our reception for after the concert. This is our last piece, a little bit Trans-Siberian Orchestra-ish. Enjoy.